are we? How's this look? Pretty. Alright. Ah, whoop. Dang it. Whew, alright, let's get back into the swing of things. Alright, so hey, heroes. Damn it. Didn't mean to do that. Hey, heroes, Isaac Zephyr here, and welcome back to Skyward Sword. Fuck off, cat. We're nearing the end of our adventure, it seems, as now we've got to go open up the Gate of Time. Which means... God fucking cat. Fuck. Oh, it has been a long weekend for me. Yeah. Had to work, so yeah, getting back into the swing of things here is not exactly the easiest. So we've got to go activate the Gate of Time, and I get the strange suspicion there aren't going to be very many side quests before then. So might as well go, and then we'll do our standard checks afterwards. Alright, and... prepare for the dive. Come on. Just gotta line up. Takes way too long to fly around in this game. Who knows, they'll make a Nintendo NX remake and remove or give you like a super flight speed or something like they did with Wind Waker in the new sale. Preferred descent area, confirm with A. I need... the sealed grounds should be fine. Yep. Ugh. Whew. But yeah, no. Whole weekend, 14 plus hour days. Hello. There's a track here I don't seem to recall. Is that nail sticking out of it? Huh. They are. They're not even lined up with anything. Well, damn. Alright then. That being the case, let's get into the temple. Not a bad look, I suppose. Alright. What awaits us? We got a full inventory of cool stuff. We got an upgraded sword. I mean, the only thing missing from the list is one harp song. Alright, let's get to this. Ah, your sword. I don't remember. There can be no doubt the sacred flames have purified this blade. Well done, Isaac. That sword holds tremendous power. That power is a sacred force. It is a divine power left to us by the gods of old, the same power that is spoken of in the Ballad of the Goddess. To look upon you is to see that same great power now flowing through you and the sword you carry. Come, Isaac, you must now open the Gate of Time. Now that the sacred force dwells within your blade, strike the Gate of Time with a skyward strike, and it will surely awaken. Climb upon the pedestal and show the gate your sword's power. Whoop. This is what happens when you take weeks off. Whoa! No, I feel the seal has given way once again. That terrible beast is awakening even as we speak. It is likely that the monster reacted to the sacred power given off by your sword. I wish it had not happened, but there is no way to open the gate. So it goes. Isaac, you must imprison the beast once again.
Alright, bring it on. This is what I've been waiting for. It's time to break out my new toy. Trust me, that flabby bag of teeth doesn't stand a chance. Well, what are we waiting for? I'm headed out there.
Well, it's good to see him doing something. Do you know what he was building? Like, seriously, do you know anything about it?
The beast is awakening from its slumber. Isaac, you must seal the beast away once more.
Alright, I'm working on it. Hopefully, bigger, better sword will make this easier.
Hey, Isaac! Try not to drool on your shirt as you stare at this amazing super weapon I've been working on. I call it the Groosinator. Leaves you speechless, doesn't it? That's only natural. You wouldn't believe how much time I put into building this beauty. Here, check it out. First, I got all the fences cluttering the area out of the way. Then I laid down rails for it to run on. All by myself, of course. I don't know what came over me. I had no clue I had a talent to make something like this, you know? Anyway, you just tell me where you want me to place my shots and I'll be hurting on that ugly monster. I don't care how beefy you are. You're bound to stumble for a few moments after taking one of my big bombs to the body. Hang on, though. That monster showed up a smidge sooner than I was expecting. There are a few final adjustments I gotta make before she can move on the rails I put down. I'll call out to you when she's ready for action. Till then, do whatever you can to hold off that beast. Alright, Groose. Didn't expect to be working with you. Ha, dang it. B's on the other controller. Whoops. Okay, and whoop. Alright. Here it comes. Alright, Floppy Toes, bring it on. Wait, are those hands? Those are hands. Shit. The Imprisoned, now with hands. Look at that! Seems like our ugly friend grew himself a pair of hands. Great timing. I hope it knows how to catch, because my machine has a mean right arm. Well, and she's all loaded up, I'll let you know. Till then, do what you need to do to stop it. Alright. What the deuce? Okay, he's using him to climb. Crack. Hey Isaac, the machine's all loaded up and ready to smash. That flabby sack of teeth tries to climb the wall, I can blast it off here with a bomb. When you want some backup fire, just send the signal with up. Alright, it's time for the goose to explode into action. Adjust the machine's position with the control stick and aim at your target with the Wii remote. Once you finish aiming, press A to launch a bomb. If it hits, you'll stun the scaly sucker. If you forget the controls, press 2 anytime you can control the goose needed to revive the basics. Ah, she packs a mean punch, doesn't she? I tell you, it was love at first sight. First time I pulled this level. I'll still order to back up with another bomb, so keep beating on that big thing till I give you the signal. I wish there was some sort of way to dodge that. Crud. I take way too much damage in this fight. Alright, down he goes. Alright. Now I have to actually focus on my sword's ring directions. Oh, come on. Okay, so I can't go around him. I've got to actually come up from below. Alright, come on. There we go. Alright, 3 swings up. Better readjust my seating position because it's getting uncomfortable. Gross. Alright. Come on. Alright, fingers are back.
Oh, aim and go for the feet. Will this help at all? Well, that seemed to have helped a little bit. At least I got a chance to catch up. Whoa! Frack. God dang it. I can't have him skip a rope. Groose, are you ready? Groose is not ready. Okay. Then let's go up. Whoop. Dang it. Keep forgetting B is on the opposite controller. Alright, he's down. And his giant arms are blocking the way, so I gotta go down and around. Whoop. Perfect. All right. Great, he's doing this again. Stop that. Ain't gonna take your shit. All right, come on. One more good swing should do it. Ah, great. Well, thankfully, I'm close. No Groose, though, so... Down you go. Whoa. Come on. Just take the hit. Ah, frog. Gotta be some way to block it. No time to think about it now, though. Gotta take him out. Really? I saw myself auto-running to the wrong side of this thing. Grab the heart. Good, you're loaded. There we go! Whew! Music stops. I take that as the assumption he's defeated. Ugh. Whew. Have a tic-tac. Get a terrible breath. Tic-tacs. Whew! And seal. Did I finally destroy him? Nope. In he goes. Whoosh. Mm.
Now, Isaac. Strike the sealing spike with a Skyward strike and restore the seal, quickly.
You know what, I'd like a good heal.
Wah!
Got it. Alright. Cool. Alright, and away with you. Awesome. There we go, 4-point seal.
Nice work there, Isaac. Of course, you couldn't have done it without me, but no one needs to thank Groose. I know I saved your tail. Now let's get that gated time thing up and running. I'll go on ahead. Yeah.
I don't know how he turned into Stallone. But I'm not gonna give a damn. Any more layers up? Just this one. Whoop. All right. Oh, it's precious health. I missed you. Whoop. And across. Perfect. Whoop. Alright, that heals us up a bit. Just in case we get spontaneously thrust into anything. It seems you were successful in imprisoning the monster again. You have my thanks, Isaac. As do you, Groose. I do not wish to dwell on what may have happened if you two hadn't been here.
Oh, you give me too much credit, Granny. You were the one who got me to stop feeling sorry for myself and put my energy into doing what I could to help. I did what was necessary to get you to... Oh, wait, fuck.
Now, you got me talking like it. I did what was necessary to get you to realize your full potential. Isaac, you must wonder what it is you've been fighting out there in the Great Pit. There is much I could tell you, but suffice to say it is the root of the evil we face. When you pass through the Gate of Time, you shall learn more. We may seal it and reseal it unto this prison 1,000 times, but it will always shatter the bonds that confine it. Such is its awesome power. We must destroy it at its source or suffer this fate again and again. There is no time to lose. Hit the gate with a Skyward strike.
Come on, already? Charge that sword of yours with the sacred force stuff Granny was talking about and zap that gate of time. Right on, Granny.
Indeed. Now, Isaac, go. Go to the gate.
Well, that was less exciting than I thought it would be. The power of cutscenes is strong in this one. Alright, it's Tetris. Well, the gate is officially made of Tetronos. Well, there goes Groose. Line piece. Crazy. Pretty. Alright, it's assembling. Alright. We've created an 8-bit gate. All Alright. We've got our gears of time. Setting things in motion. Awesome. Gotta spend a minute to look cool. Do not fear it. This is what we have waited for. At long last, the gate has been reactivated. Standing before you is a path that transcends the flow of time. It is a portal to the past, to the very place where Zelda now awaits. Go bravely, Isaac. If ever, as I suspect, the reunion with Zelda you fought so far for lies beyond this gate. All right, then. Let's do this. Save the world. Nah, don't worry about me. I'm gonna hang back here, Isaac. That stupid monster doesn't know when to quit. Granny here keeps yapping on and on about how we never know when it might bust free again. Someone's gotta stick around and guard the place. Might as well be me! Besides, if I'm not here, who's gonna look out for the old girl?
It's nice to see that you've appreciated as a knight, Groose.
And you know what? Nah, forget about it.
You know what? I really appreciate the growth of Groose's character throughout this.
When you see Zelda, tell her I said, "What's up?"
I mean, like, I know I won the knight thing, but I kind of want to see him. Him become a knight in due time. He's grown a lot. He deserves it. Alright. Let's go. Right then.
Whoop!
Looked more like it was a jump thing rather than a run, but okay. We'll run. Alright, and where are we now? The Temple of Hylia. Hey, Impa. Bird statue. Always a plus. Door is locked, so we can't escape that way. Divine light. Alright, what's up, Impa?
Hey. At last, I've been expecting you, Isaac. You are doubtless overwhelmed, so I will explain things as simply as I can. This is the Temple of Hylia, though it will become known as the Sealed Temple sometime in the future. You stand in the past, ages before your own time. Here, the goddess Hylia was only just sealed away, demise. And little time has passed since the goddess sent the outcropping of rock into the sky that would one day become Skyloft. It is true to its name, you have passed through the gate of time to an era in the distant past. You will have many questions, but for now you must proceed back through the gate doors behind you. It is there that the person you've risked life and blood to defend waits for you. Alright. Alright. Shake the sweat off.
You've come so far, Isaac. I'm glad you made it. I imagine Impa filled you in on everything. We've traveled very far from home, to the distant past. In this era, the wounds inflicted on the land during the battle between the goddess and the demon king known as Demines have not yet healed. All the fairy tales about the war we heard growing up in Skyloft, incredible as it may seem, they appear to be all too real. I think it's time you learned the whole story. Let me try to explain. The old gods created a supreme power that gave anyone who possessed it the ability to shape reality and fulfill any desire. They called it the Triforce. In his thirst to make the world his own, Demise readied a massive army of monsters for war. He sought to take the Triforce for himself, by force. The goddess feared for her people. She used her power to send both them and the Triforce into the sky on a slice of earth she cut away from the land. This floating rock became the new home of our people. In time, it became to be known as Skyloft. After a long and fierce battle, the goddess Hylia succeeded in sealing away Demise. However, soon after the Demon King was imprisoned, it became clear that the seal would not hold long against his fearsome power. Hylia had suffered grave injuries in her battle with the Demon King. She knew that if he broke free again, there would be no stopping him. And if the Demon King were to free himself, it would mean the end of the world for all things of this land. In order to put an end to the Demon King, Hylia devised two separate plans and set them both into motion.
This is a lot to take in, Zelda.
Go on. I'm actually slightly interested, apparently. First, she created Fi. She made the spirit that resided in your sword to serve a single purpose, to assist her chosen hero in a mission. Her second plan was to abandon her divine form and transfer her soul to the body of a mortal. She made this sacrifice, as you have likely guessed, so that the supreme power created by the old gods could one day be used. For while the supreme power of the Triforce was created by the gods, all of its power can never be wielded by one. Knowing this power was her last and only hope, the goddess gave up her divine powers and her immortal form. You've probably figured it out by now, haven't you, Isaac? You're the chosen hero, and I, Zelda, am the goddess reborn as a mortal. The day of the ceremony, Ghirahim's tornado tossed me out of the sky and down to the world below. I was nearly captured by the demonic forces, but I was rescued at the last moment by the old woman who lives in the sealed grounds. I had no memory at all of my existence as Hylia, but she explained it to me. She helped me to remember who I was and what I had to do. I set out to pray at the goddess statues located in each temple across the land. Each statue stirred up memories within me. After I visited them all, Impa, an agent of the goddess, led me here to the past. All of this is part of the same great effort to prevent the revival of Demise. Stripped of his true physical form by the seal that binds him, he takes the shape of an abomination. But even in his hideous state, he's more than capable of devouring this land if we allow him to do what he desires. We must stop him from freeing himself from the seal that imprisons him, at any cost. This is what I intend to remain here in this time and place, to sustain the seal as best I can. As long as I continue this vigil, we may be able to prevent the Demon King from fully reviving himself in our own time. Okay. I must maintain the seal that I created so long ago, and keep it strong for as long as I am able. With the memories of my former life returning to me, I can see now that this is my purpose. Isaac, the goddess created Fi and the Great Blade. She's a part of you for very specific reasons. For the task of standing against Demise in the monstrous form he now assumes rests solely on your shoulders. Back in our own time, you've already driven him back to his prison twice now. I can't thank you enough for that, Isaac. During your During your long journey, you've grown so much. So have my eyes. Good Christ. Look at that! Good God, I want that as like a gif. You learned wisdom from the solving devious puzzles and traps. You gained power by honing and tempering both yourself and your sword. And by overcoming the trials set before you by the goddess, you found true courage.
And like gratuitous amounts of E.
Now that those qualities reside in you, you are worthy of wielding the power the old gods left behind for our kind. You can claim the Triforce. Okay. my lady. Valiant hero, you have endured many hardships and journeyed far in your quest to reach this place. Along your travels, you have found wisdom, power, and courage. And for this, I shall bless your sword with the goddess's power. May it give you and your sword the strength to drive back the abomination that threatens this land. The mark you see upon the back of your hand is proof that you are the hero of legend and that within you dwells sacred power. It is the mark of the Triforce. Stand now, Isaac. Draw your sword. Ah, Cat, I hope you can't be picked up by the goddamn microphone. Shiny. The goddess has blessed your blade, and the Master Sword has at last achieved its ultimate form. The sword is now imbued with the mythical power to drive back demons, and only Isaac may wield it. Isaac, before I say another word, I feel like I owe you an apology. You see, the mark of the Triforce on your hand is a symbol of the greatest power in this world. If you can obtain the actual Triforce, we will have the power to vanquish demise once and for all. The problem is, among the countless souls in this world, only a select few, those with an unbreakable spirit, can wield its might. It's impossible to know the true reason why the old gods created the Triforce, but I have a theory of my own. The gods created the Triforce, yet they specifically designed it so that their own kind could never use its power. Somehow, I think that may have been their way of giving hope to all the mortal beings of the land. Which brings us back to you. To face demise and give the land hope, the goddess Hylia needed someone with an unbreakable spirit. That someone is you, Isaac. But spirit alone wasn't enough. You had to overcome many trials and awaken the hero within yourself so that you could wield that supreme power. And so I knew that if it meant saving Zelda, you would throw yourself headfirst into any danger without even a moment's doubt. I used you. I can't begin to tell you how sorry I am for pulling you into all of this, Isaac. But you have to understand, this is a war, and the fate of the land hangs in the balance. I need your strength to tip the scales in our favor. All that may be well-intentioned and true, but it doesn't mean it's right, and it doesn't excuse my actions. But I'm prepared to pay the price for what I've done. To ensure that the seal holds, I will remain here in this time, deep in sleep for thousands of years. Isaac, I can't say it enough. I'm so sorry for the way I had to involve you in all this. You don't have to go sleep for 1,000 years, I'll solve the problem. But until my memory of things before our lifetime returned to me, I had no idea we were fated to carry such a heavy destiny. Before all this, I was happy just spending my days hanging around with you in Skyloft. I wanted that feeling to last forever. Doesn't have to. No, don't do it. God damn it. No. No. Come on. No. I worked so hard. While it's true that I am Hylia reborn, I'm still my father's daughter. And your friend. I'm still your Zelda. No, come on! When demise is finally gone, there will be no more need for the seal that binds him, and then I'll be able to wake up. I'm going to ask you a favor, sleepyhead. Ever since we were kids, I'd always be the one to wake you up when you slept in. But this time, when all this is over, will you come wake me up? I promise. Oh, God, I have the most vocal cat in the world. No! Fuck. Ugh. Damn it, now I got a promise to keep. Damn it. I should have done better. I could have done better. I know I couldn't because it's a game and this is intended, but still. I need to vocalize myself. Makes me feel better. So we ran a little long, but that's it. Till next time, this will be Isaac Zephyr, signing out. I'll see y'all later, heroes.